German Reader Theatre brings you the golden age of the Song Dynasty.
Hello, and welcome to German Reader Theatre. Today, we are taking you on a journey throughout the eons of time. Back to an age when the pale-faced geisha
was considered a tan.
You guessed it, the golden age of the Song Dynasty. This Chinese age of academic, economic, social, and technological achievement spanned from 760 to 1276 AD. Throughout our journey, we will examine ancient Chinese footage and also delve into deep Chinese culture that is the Song. Around 1044, gunpowder became widely used as an incendiary weapon in Chinese arrows, catapults, rockets, and even cannons. It was not until much later that gunpowder became widely used in firearms and fireworks that we see in Chinese celebrations today.
While there was some medical knowledge before the Song reign, the Golden Age marked a time of great Chinese medical achievement. We find in Song text the first appearance of medical physicians, the first reports of illnesses, and diagnosis of organ-related body issues. Also, medical theories were extensively tested and taken data for the first time in history. The Materia Medica, a Song collection of medical ailments, contains 1,082 herbal remedies, along with a modernized test for diabetes by the tasting of urine.
Ooh, diabetes.
Song mathematics studies were mainly focused around cartography, engineering, and astronomy, but the pursuit of these subjects also led to the unearthing of many new algebraic and geometric ideas. Yuan Hui, a Song mathematician, came up with a proof for Euclid's 43rd proposition of parallelograms, as long as became the first man to use negative coefficients in an equation involving x. Yuan also introduced the symbol of zero into the Chinese language, which would from then on take the place of blank spaces written in Chinese counting rods. I got a blank space, baby, and I'll write the zero in place of the blank space. Like other dynasties, Song China had many various social classes, but each class still followed the same set of Neo-Confucian values. Zhu Xie, one of Song China's greatest Neo-Confucian thinkers, led the collaboration to create sagehood ideals, along with many other scholars. Being a sage was the Buddhist equivalent to receiving enlightenment, and a sage was fair in all life respects due to his strict adheration to Neo-Confucian codes. In Song culture, women would often go to great lengths in order to ensure a spouse in the future. Nowadays, to attract men, women either triple their squat regimen or endure copious injections of Botox. But in ancient Song China, what women would do is bind their feet, so in the future, the tiny little feet would grow into the shape of a beautiful lotus bud. The foot binding process broke bones and often caused gangrene to flourish in the open oozing sore. But anything for the D, am I right? As you can imagine, foot binding was the ideal Song touch of beauty, and any girl that was caught walking cross-legged down the street made a man go bonkers. During the end times of the Song Dynasty, it ultimately fell to its political turmoil and the attack of Genghis Khan. Now, while my boy Genghis is a bit rowdy guy and his Mongols did attack the Song Empire, who can deny the great Song Genghis Khan? I mean, have you seen that guy dance to his rowdy ABBA tunes?